Farmers are right now taking to suburban streets across Aotearoa, protesting a raft of government legislation they say unfairly impacts them. Our reporters are live at protests across the nation. We begin with Maddie Lloyd in Alexandra. Kia ora, Maddie.
Good afternoon, Melissa, from Pioneer Park in Alexandra. It's one of about 60 or so protests that's happening around the country today. There's tractors lining the park here, and you can see all the utes and dogs parked up behind me. Why this protest is happening, the rural community in New Zealand are protesting against what they call a growing list of a tsunami of regulations and policies that the government is putting in place. There's a number of those, such as the fresh water policy that is significantly going to change how farmers operate day to day. But what is being called as the final straw is the government's clean car scheme. That's imposing a penalty for high emission vehicles such as utes and tractors that are used widely on farms in New Zealand. The rural communities say that these policies, they cannot abide by them and they're simply impossible to follow. And what's interesting about the clean car scheme is there is no legitimate EV replacement for utes in New Zealand at this time, and farmers say it's impossible to adhere to these rules and policies, and they want them either scrapped or revisited and re-looked at. They want to be listened to, so they hope that today's protest will make the government sit up and listen and maybe join them around the table to consult the rural community of New Zealand for these policies and regulations going forward.
Pretty nice looking day in Alexandra today. Thanks very much, Maddie Lloyd. But it's not just rural towns. Our major centres are also the site of a number of protests. Isaac Gunson's following the procession making its way into central Christchurch. Tēnā koe, Isaac. What's happening where you are?
Yeah, good afternoon, Melissa. Well, these tractors and utes have been making their way from all across Canterbury, meeting and then converging, heading down State Highway 76, and now they are here, having encircled Cathedral Square in central Christchurch. The farm dogs are letting out literal howls of protest against these proposed government legislation. Now, of course, those tractors and utes have come in their hundreds. The latter of those vehicles could face up to added fees of up to $5,000 for an imported vehicle. That's one of just many pieces of legislation that these people here are protesting, howling in protest against.
Ngā mihi nui. Thanks, Isaac. And there's been widespread travel disruption in Tamaki Makaurau, Auckland, as farmers made their way from Drury into the CBD. Emily van Veldhoven's been following the protesters here in Auckland, and she joins us now from Aotea Square. Hi, Emily.
Melissa, sorry, I'll just correct you there. We're actually at Ellerslie Showgrounds now, but it's almost like every man and his dog, or should I say every man and his tractor, has been out on Auckland's northern motorway this morning. We joined them at about 8 o'clock from Pukekohe, where we then met up with the Majuri and we started that motorway trail with them. But the support has just been unreal. Every overbridge that we went under, there was tens or twenties of people with these big signs showing their support. Obviously, a bit of a traffic disruption this morning, saw a few fingers pulled towards the farmers, but of course I just want to get their voices heard. So we parked up here now at Ellerslie. There are only a handful of tractors here, but that is because they're still coming here. Now, a handful of them actually drove down Queen Street about an hour ago with quite a few supporters there as well. I guess they're just playing catch up now, but they are going to be coming here. We will be hearing from a representative and then they will be partaking in that big bark up or howl up. So if anything else comes from that, we'll get back to you shortly.
Well, thanks very much from Ellerslie. Thank you, Emily.